Good morning, Tehmina Khan is here in TK Maths S1. In today's video, which is video number 2 on Pythagoras theorem, we will study extension questions, and in the next one will be challenging question. This is the series of videos in which I have tried to cover a few concepts of year 7 and 8 which are here. They are interconnected. So one after the other I will upload the videos. Please press like and subscribe button. You will get the indication of the next videos which I will upload. Okay, so we have already done the basic regular question. Now we are going to the extension task, and topic is Pythagoras theorem. Achha, by the way, remember when it will be asked from year 7 and 8 students, number are taken such which can be solved without calculator or little bit of division or multiplication. I have taken from different sites like Corbett Maths. Most of the question I've tried to take from there because it's easy to understand for students. So let's start. In this question, the distance from a point on the ground to the base of the tree is 1.8. So this distance from here till here is 1.8, which is given to you. The distance from a point on the ground to the top of the tree is 20 meters. So from here till here, it is given to you. You have to find the height of the tree. At a glance, it is not a right angle triangle, but you have to be intelligent enough here. If you draw a line from here, it will become a right angle triangle. Agreed? If you draw a line from here, and this height is same as x, which is given here. So that's why you will simply apply Pythagoras theorem to find out this height here, and you will get it. So what is the Pythagoras theorem? Do you remember it? 90 degrees here, this is your hypotenuse, so it will be 20 square equals to 18 square plus x square, right? Do not make a mistake which I explained last time, that you just make x a subject here directly and write down the other two numbers as a addition, right? As a addition, it will not be part here right now. So if you write the basic rule as it is stated, you can avoid making mistake. So 20 square is what? 400. And what is 18 square? I told you, you have to learn tables, sorry, square table till 20. So it is 321 plus x square. So 400 minus 321 is what? Quickly tell me. Yes. Sorry. It will be 76. So x square is equals to 76. So x is equal to root 76. If calculator is allowed, because question is asking answer in one decimal place, so you can give here. So it will be 8.717. So you can write 8.717 equals 72. Okay. Oh, sorry. It is saying in one decimal place, so 8.7. Okay. Now this question, I'm just taking different types which can be asked or which will help you to develop the concept here. You know, if you see, it is a rectangle, sides opposite are same. I can pick up this triangle ABD. Which triangle? ABD. It will be my right angle triangle. So when question says find out the area of it, I need to find out this side. Let me call it x. So now if I apply Pythagoras theorem, it will be 13 square, let me change the color, is equal to 5 square plus x square, right? 13 square is what? 169. And 5 square is 25. I'm bringing it to this side. Then you will subtract 25 from it. What will you get? 144. And then you will take a square root of 144, which will be what? 12. So that side is 12. Now you can easily find the area. Area of a rectangle is what? Length into width. So it will be 5 into 12. 60. And what unit you will use? The square centimeter, right? So this is how extension happened. You have to apply some other concept to figure out size. What about this one? What do you say? Do you remember the properties of isosceles triangle? Yes, when you drop the height from the vertex where two equal sides are meeting, it divides the opposite side into equal parts. So now if I see, this is making one triangle, right? So I can say 8 squared equals to, because this is my hypotenuse with respect to 90 degree, 8 squared is equals to h squared plus 2.5 squared. 8 is 64. 2.5 square, you can multiply, okay? It is an easy number, you can easily multiply. Even this question can come in your exam also, because it's not a big number. And you will get here 6.25. You can subtract also. After that it will be complicated here, so just leave your answer like this. So in the next question video we will start challenging questions. So thank you very much for watching it. Please press like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. My throat is not very good right now, so just pray for me. Take care. Allah Hafiz.